Well, good morning. Good morning, everybody. So, today I just wanted to make a quick video on a bit of damage, I guess. So, a lot of people told me that I don't need any sort of healer or tanks in monster battles, so I'm just gonna attack this monster real quick, and I'm gonna switch back to another level 1. A different one, level 1, so I don't get that 14 attack bonus. So I really don't want to wait that long, so let's just speed this up a little bit. Alright, shouldn't be long. But oh yeah, by the way, this is a new mic that I've got. I think it should be a lot better. But as you can see, whenever I attack this with only times one multiplier to this Jade, whatever the fuck, I did 28 damage. That is pretty freaking good. And I didn't have that multiplier for my first attack. So now I'm gonna attack this one, and then I'll go back to attacking this one with no sort of, tank or healer. So you can see the damage difference between the two. So I will be right back with that one. Alright, so as you can see, there is no sort of attack bonus right here. So let's attack this again with no healer. I could change out some of these, but you know, this probably seems like the best bet. I might change out this one later for like a second, like, or a third attack, so you can see what it's like without her. So let's speed this up. No, fuck it. Let's just throw up a 50. Oh yeah, this is my other mic. This is also doubling as like a test video to see which mic is a little bit louder. Who's this guy? TQT. So, only a couple more seconds before it hits. And shabam. Oh, that did a significant amount of damage more. Alright, but I still have something else to show you guys. I'll be right back with that one. Alright, so once again we're here without any sort of bonus up here, as you can see. Let's attack again, but this time I'm going to get rid of this person. I'm going to add on the Snow Queen or whatever. So that might make a difference. Alright, I'll see you guys once it hits. So you guys can see, I like to keep it, like, going so you guys know I'm not doing any sort of, like, trickery. It's still at 0%. Just come on. Just hit this one. Just hit this one. Come on, guys. I need a team. Alright, so this, in my thought, it should do more damage. Well, I guess I was wrong. Alright, time to go for a fourth test. Be right back. Alright, time to test again. This time, it's not gonna be the Snow Queen because she's way too weak. Instead, I'll do healer, just no assassins. At least that's what I believe should work. The assassins tend to get behind the enemy and direct all the attacks away from the other group, sometimes leading it away. So I feel like sometimes you can get better attacks without assassins, but that's just been my opinion. That didn't do much damage at all. What was my best group again? Oh, sorry guys, Coach, you're a bit much. Fuck. 1.5% left. Of course. Okay, let's hit it again. Except this way. Because apparently this hits the hardest, but I think that was just a lucky hit where it got 36. This is also with the 14% bonus, so with doing about 30 damage each hit, 29, 30, that'd be an extra 1% damage, so we're looking at about 33%, or all the way up to maybe 39 to 40%. 33 or 40. Gonna range from 33 to 40% for this hit. It's almost guaranteed. Alright, thank you for getting that saber. Alright, so I think the evidence is very conclusive. The best heroes to use for at least the Jade is the Night Raven, the Bomb Goblin, this lady. This guy, oh, not this guy, this lady, and then, for me, Black Crow. So don't use any sort of, healer or, tank at all. And by the way, this is gonna be a little tidbit of information, my Colosseum rank is right now of 198, earlier I said something about that. Yeah, I just recently broke 200 by killing that guard. But for me, the best formation I can have is typically whenever I attack, let's scrap this. So I usually have, of course, this one, this one, this one, this one, and then I throw on that. So whenever, okay, so you guys have to buy her if you want to do good in the the Colosseum, because I don't know if it says in any of her skills. Cast protection. All right, right here. Cast protection on basically all allies, absorbing attacks for 8 seconds. That means for 8 seconds, you cannot take damage. This is by far one of the most overpowered things I've ever come across. And if you look up in Colosseum, that one has it. That one has it. They have it. Change again. Boom, they have it. They have her again. They have her again. She is by far the best person to have in Colosseum. I could probably take this person because they do not have her. But I don't have any more tries right now. So I just kind of like go around looking to see who does not have her. But everybody in the top ranks always has her as a part of their little group. I can almost guarantee it. This one I'm... Yeah, this one I should be able to take. She's not in it. But I've never seen that kid's ability right there, wherever he is. I haven't seen his ability before, so I don't know what he does. So I might not be able to take it. But again, as you guys noticed, with the conclusive evidence, stay away from tanks and healers. I'll see you guys in the next video.